Things God did, the things good that happened in my life, God did. I'm just very familiar book of the Bible, but not familiar passages. We choose the book of St. Matthew chapter 5. We know those are called, we look at the familiarization of that passage book. We call them the Beatitudes. The Sermon of the Mount, I'm sorry. The Sermon of the Mount, we use that, the sixth chapter of the Beatitude. But nestled in between there is the passage of scripture that Jesus speaks to concerning life and life expectations. I want to read in verse number 42 in St. Matthew chapter 5. It says, "Give to him that asketh thee, and to him that would borrow of thee, turn thou not away. Ye have heard that it has been said, thou shalt love thy neighbor and hate thy enemies. But I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, and do good to them that hate you, and pray for them that despitefully use you and persecute you, that ye may be the children of your Father, that you may be the children of your Father which is in heaven. For he maketh his sun, S-U-N, to shine on the evil and on the good. And he sendeth rain to the just and the unjust. For if ye love them which love you, what reward have ye? Do ye not even the publicans do the same? If ye salute your brethren only, what good do ye do more than others? Do not even publicans also?" Did I say Republicans? Republicans also. Hey, thank you, Jesus. "Be ye therefore perfect, even as your Father, which is in heaven, is perfect." The word perfect there implies full development, fully growing into maturity of godliness. Not fully maturity as a human, but full maturity in godliness. Not sinless perfection, because we're born in sin. No one human can be sinless. One of the comedians always said, I can't remember which one it was, said, when a baby born into the world, they come in alive. You don't even hit them, and they come in crying. That's why doctors have to hit them, just spank that butt, make sure they cry. This is a relationship of God's kindness, the Father. That shows his great love and his compassion towards us. He picks it up again in the book of Saint John, chapter number 8. He's speaking to the scribes and the Pharisees again. Says sometimes they just really get under the skin. And I'm going to read to you these passages. Verse number 18 in St. John 18. "I am one that bear witness of myself, and the Father sent me to bear witness of me." That's our profession. We perfect, we grow, we mature in the knowledge of who God is through Jesus Christ. "They said unto him, where is thy Father? Jesus answered, neither ye know me, nor my Father. For if ye had known me, you should have known the Father also. These words spake Jesus in the treasury, but as he taught in the temple, and no man laid hands on him, for his hour is not yet come. Then said Jesus again unto them, I go my way, and ye shall seek me, and shall die in your sins. Whither I go, ye cannot come. Then said the Jews, will he kill himself? Because he says, whither I go, he cannot go. They thought Jesus was speaking of suicide. Jesus turns to them and says, ye are from beneath. I am from above. Ye are of this world. I am not of this world. I say therefore unto you, if ye should die in your sins, if ye believe not that I am he, ye shall die in your sins." Father God, I bless and thank you. I bless and praise you, Lord God, for your word today in Jesus' name. Jesus continues in verse number 44, and he says, "Ye are of your father, the devil, and the lust of your father, which ye do. He was a murderer from the beginning, and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it." My message today, who's your dad? Who's your dad? Who's your dad? My daddy is the God of perfection through the Lord Savior Jesus Christ, his son. My father is the heavenly God of all creation. And brothers and sisters, he created the angels also. But he did not give them what we have, free will. This one, the son of the morning, a.k.a. Lucifer, chose in the book of Isaiah, he said, I chose to be above the stars, above God. I want to be better than them. I want to be like unto God. And because of that, the corruption of what we see, the impact of immorality and evil came into the universe, not the world. The universe, because the world is where we are. The earth is the Lord, and the fullness thereof. He kicked 2/3 of the angels out of heaven. They were cast out along with Satan. So now we see the spirit has to find a place to dwell in on earth, because angels are not earthly, so they do have no earthly being. We've seen many movies and many documentaries of different types of angels growing up and being giants and things of these natures, but the only thing that we understand is spirit. We understand spirit by spirit. Jesus speaks to them and reminds them that we are not of this world. The angels are not of this world, but they come into this world that they are ministering spirits to us. They do not have control of us, but they give us control of our lives. The same way the demonic spirit does. Jesus says, you are the lie. And your father is the father of life. And the truth is not in you. He recognized who the world that is. I am in the world, but I'm not of the world. I live in this world, but I'm living to live again. I'll say that again. I'm living to live again. I want to live again. I'll say that. The Christian education department one. I can't wait to see my granddaughter go across the stage. I can't wait till she get her bachelor in science and arts and music, whatever she feels she desires, she goes to. Those are things I anticipate with great expectations, but nevertheless, I still get up every morning and say, Lord, keep me rapture ready. Don't let me fall into presumptuous sins. The psalmist writes in Psalm 18. Don't let me fall into 19, the presumptuous sins. I do not want to be doing things that's not the will of God or things that are contrary to him, because my father is life and truth. Sister Sonia Montgomery always has four statements. State when she comes here, I talk to my daddy and my daddy talks to me. Yeah. And when I hear his voice, I obey. Sister Mona heard the voice of my daddy through my mom and she obeyed. See, spirits, our ministry spirits, always going to make you do good. We looked at the scale of life. Remember the devil on one shoulder and the angel on the other one? Amen. We have cartoonized those things as images, but really, those are spirits that they have to have an incubator. They have to have a place or a mind or thought to come to. I've been, one of my good friends, Sister Rose Clifton, Rose Walker Clifton, she was doing something on Facebook one day. She says, I don't even, sometimes she works on a radio station, WBBM News Radio. And she says sometimes I get in my car and I just leave it on silent so I can just talk to the Father. I just talk to him, and I've been doing that lately. Yesterday, for example, I was so wrapped up in talking to the Father, I missed my turn. Amen, praise the Lord. But I still got to my destination. See, I had to get you. It was to me. I told the congregants at the Urshan board meeting workshop, I said, I had a long time to talk with God and more time to talk with you about me talking to God. Because the more we talk to him, the more he hears our prayers or our, I heard a rabbi say, we have conversations with God. I love that. One of my dear friends and sister, our district elder of our church, Dr. Barbara Reed, wrote a book called Communicating with God, Communication with God. And in that book, she says, you must have conversation with God. You must talk to him the way you talk naturally to your natural father, God. He hears your spiritual things and he knows your natural needs. So when Jesus gets into this place and he says that I'm not of this world, he says, I'm not born of this world. I was born of this world through Mary. But my spirit is God. Johnny James is always intrigued as to our thoughts. He said that Jesus was physical on his mother's side, but spiritual on his father's side. All the attributes of Jesus is not Joseph, but God. then in chapter number 9, I love to use these parallels of scriptures, and I've shared with a lot of my teachings, that Jesus kept saying, I am, I am. If you look at verse number 12 in St. John chapter 8, he says, I am the light of the world. And then verse number 18, he says, I am the one that sent me. He's constantly using the I am, which is Elohim or Yahweh. When Moses asked Jehovah, who is he? Who should I say sent me? He says, say to them that I am sent you. And Jesus used the quotation, I am, 42 times in the book of St. John. Those who are doing the Bible studies with us in the numerical order, the number of scriptures, 42 represents the generations that Jesus came through. Each time he says, I am, he was referring to himself through God. He says in verse number 23, he says, and he said to them, ye are from beneath, I am from above. He said, and ye are this world, I am not of this world. And then in the same verse 24, he says, I am he. He speaks again and continues to get to the variation of the part that we get to the last verse of this chapter, or next to last verse, verse 58. He says, Jesus said, oh, verily, verily, I say unto you, before Abraham was, I am. He declares that I am this continuously. And even in St. John chapter 9, he says, I must do the work of him that sent me while it's day. But verse number 5, he says, as long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world. And he gets so full of God in him. And then he reaches over to the next chapter, number 10. He turns around and says, in verse number 7, he says, I am the door of the sheep. And then in verse number 9, he says, I am the door. He continuously puts the Father's glory, that who is his daddy, who's your daddy, on himself through him. Verse number 10, he says, the thief cometh not, but to steal, to kill, and destroy. He gives the antiquities of the power of the greatness of who he is through God and says, I am come that you might have life and that you might have it more abundantly. And then he turns and says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for his sheep. Verse 14, he says, I am the good shepherd, and my sheep, they know me, and they know me by my name. He gets to a point where he's so tired of men asking him questions. He says to St. John 10 and 30, he says, who are you? What is he to you? And Jesus says, I and my Father are one. I and my Father are one. He says to them, he says in verse number 15, chapter 11, he says, I am glad for your sake. He says, that I was not there when Lazarus died, that he might prove who he is. In verse number 25, Jesus said to Martha, says, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believes on me, though he was dead, should not die but live again. He continues to give his attributes of who he is, and he reminds us to lift up the name of God. In chapter number 12, verse number 32, he says, and if I be lifted up from the earth, I will draw all men unto me. Because in verse 46, he says, I am come a light unto the world. He continues saying, I am, I am, I am, I am. There's 42 of them. I don't want to go over all of them, but you can do it in your own Bible studies. You just you can say technology, you can just Google how many times Jesus says, I am in St. Matthew, or in St. John. And it'll come up and give you 42 of them, and it'll show you where they all are. But see, I did this hand study. My pastor preached a service once, going home, back in 2010. And it still reminds, especially, that I have to keep account of all those in our minds. Because my daddy makes me responsible. I am a responsible being, and my Father and I are one. He's my dad. I was lost one day, me and my twin sister. One time my mom did it on purpose. She does get dragging behind, taking our time, playing, making hot shots and things like that. And my mother waved about 3 blocks ahead, we were lost. And the man said, Well, your kids would be crying. We lost our mom. We lost our mom. We never lose your mom. She'll laugh way up ahead watching us. He says, what's your mom's name? Because we were kids, we said, mom, 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 mom. Oh, well, what's your daddy's name? I said, daddy, that's all I knew. All I know is Jesus is my daddy. I know who my father is, so you don't have to ask me who's my daddy. They got mad at the people at Walmart for putting a card out says to the baby's daddy on Father's Day. They are what they are. So if this is a capitalistic nation, everybody wants to bank in on something they didn't get something for. So Walmart took them off the shelves, the Kmart, which one was Target, one of the stores, took all those cars off the shelf. Target, thank God, took them off the shelf. Because it's a repulsive. How is it repulsive? The child was born, he was not born out of an incubator. He wasn't a test tube child. So he has a father. So sometimes you never know who your father is. Adopted children. Never know. I know who my dad is. I was adopted way back on Calvary's Hill of Sorrow. Where sin's demands were paid, that raised the hope for tomorrow. Now see, my Jesus, Jehovah, he chose the Jews. Jesus says, I came to get you, you mine. See, the Jews, they had Jehovah had to be their dad, because he chose them. But Jesus says, my father and your father are one, because I chose you. Hallelujah. Of a story in my closing, little boy was sharing some thoughts about his father, and the little boy who had a stepdaddy, adopted father. He said, my daddy loves me. He gives me toys, he gives me games, he gives me videos, he gives me candy, he gives me all the things I want, because that's my daddy. Your daddy can't do that. The little boy looked at him and said, my father is special. I wasn't born of him. He chose me. He came out of all the people of the world, all the children that he could have chose from, and he didn't choose none of them. He chose me. That's special. And he does for me everything that I need that he's able to do for me. But the thing that he does for me unconditionally that your father has to do, he loves me.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I know who my dad is. One of my favorite songs I will be listening to on the way home today. I play it every Father's Day about a man who died in World War II. And he had seven kids, and his wife was left a widow. And she met a man, and this man fell in love with her, with herself and her seven kids. And he took care of them, and they said he took all seven kids in, married the mom, and he took the kids in, gave them his name. He says, now my mom is married to the man with the big wide grin. I think I'm calling this man father. I think I'm calling this man love. What manner of love is this that the Father would bestow upon us that we should be called the sons and children of God? I say, wow, awesome, great. What next? Ice cream and cake? Father, I thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That was the station identification call to the sisters who brought ice cream and cake to church.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I thank them because I know it's the proof that we need to know that what we hear becomes knowledge. Jesus says, I am the Father one. Jesus says, I am the way. I am the truth and the life. He says in verse 11, I got to stop. I won't stop. I'm trying to stop, but I don't want to stop. Amen. Praise the Lord. Verse 11, chapter number 14, I'm stop. I won't say another word besides the word that I say about the word and this word and this last word I'll say about this word about my daddy today. Amen. He says, believe me, verse 11, that I am in the Father. He said, I am not the Father. He said, I am in the Father, and the Father is in me. Or else, if you don't believe that, then just believe me for the very work's sake. What you see, the old secular song says, what you see is what you get.
Yes.
And so I say, Lord, I'm getting all the joy that floods my soul. I'm getting all the blessings of Abraham. I'm getting all the love that the Father that loved me unconditionally, just as I was. I was weary, I was wounded, I was sad. I had no hope, I had no joy. Oh, I was happy, but I wasn't glad. And some people are glad, but they're not happy. I'm happy and glad.
Yeah.
I'm so excited. I can barely wait till the service over with and go around the petition. And those of you here know what I'm talking about. Amen. Praise the Lord. I get joy when I think about what he's done for me. And I get happy when I think about who's my daddy. I don't know who my daddy is. The little boy says, I don't know who my daddy is. Yes, you do, little fella. He's the father of life. He sits high and looks low. You don't know who your daddy is? No, my mom never told me. Let me tell you about him. Let me tell you about a man. Woo! Hallelujah! And I start telling the little boy about his father. He said, he's my daddy too. I said, yeah, everybody's daddy. Yeah. He don't mind sharing himself with everybody. No, he don't mind sharing anything he has. He'll share not only will he share what he has here with you, but he's prepared a place for you. In my father's house, there are many mansions. I was on Lake Forest Drive, driving on Sheridan Road. Any of you have ever done it? There's another little street called Sheridan Place, and then there's East Sheridan. Those are mansions inside of mansions. All back then, I got a client back there. And I'm driving my little. There's nothing compared to what heaven will be. Eyes have not seen. But I was going, close my mouth. Just beautiful. What, look what man can do. What do you think the man can do that? What do you think the God who made man? Doesn't he give us all these thoughts? Doesn't he give us all these imaginations? Doesn't he give us all these images? Doesn't he help us create things for Simona? Doesn't he help us to create things to him that you do for his glory? But it's done by you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Woo! Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you. But today, is there anybody here? Is there anybody here that loves my Jesus? Anybody here that loves my Lord? I want to know if you love my Jesus. I want to know if you love the Lord enough to say, Lord, I'm available to you. My will I give to you. I'll do what you say. You'll use me, Lord. To show someone the way. Whew. Glory. Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And he is the light, is the light of men. And if someone here today has not been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sin, you have opportunity to come and know the Father, to learn him, and to know who he is. Just to know him. Just to know him. He is so good. I'm so thankful. And I just say, Lord, to you. Lord, I come to you just as I am. Weary, wounded, and sad. But I receive this word from the Lord today. And I give it to his people, to his congregation. Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Let the church say amen.
Amen.
Is anyone here today?
Say amen.
They want to come to Jesus just as you are. Depart and have the removing and washing of your sins through baptism in Jesus' name. Being filled up with the gifts of the Holy Ghost for the promise unto you and to your children, to many that are far off. Many of the Lord our God shall come in Jesus' name. Give our praise. Amen. Amen. Thank you for your time, for your service, and for your gifts. I appreciate this Father's Day more than the one last year, because this is another year that we can celebrate. I'll tease people that now the holidays can officially begin now. After Father's Day, all the other holidays fall into place. 4th of July, President Obama's birthday. This will be a national holiday. Watch. I guarantee y'all it's going to be watch. August 4th, you're going to have a presidential pardon for what's the president name? He'll say Donald J. Trump, and he's going to say, I'm going to declare President Obama's birthday a national holiday by the law. God can use anybody. He can use anybody. Yeah. Amen. Use anything. Use a donkey. If you use a donkey, why can't you use an ass?
Yes,
somebody called that, didn't you, right away?
Yeah.
Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. As I was saying, Father, tell me y'all say. Thank you, Lord God. name of Jesus, continue to pray for our president. He's on a mission. And the only person giving him free course to is God. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Father, we bless and thank you for this day, for your word, Lord God. Keep our bodies conditioned and cool during these next couple of days. If you have neighbors who are elderly looking on, call your relatives. Those are maybe experiencing dehydration and things. If you have pets, make sure you keep them warm in their buckets and their bowls and things like that. Don't walk them out in the middle of the day. Walk them in the cool of the day, early parts of the morning. They dehydrate fast. It may not seem like it when you see their tongue sticking out there trying to cool themselves off. So be cognizant of them. You see people doing the same thing. Remind people to consume less alcohol consumption because and coffee and things because those caffeine really affects the body. So Lord, we get the early taste of summer now on the greatest day of the year, Father's Day. And we thank you, Lord God, you have blessed each one of us here. Take us from this place, but not from that presence. So we meet again, whether we are earth or in glory. Keep us raptured ready to serve thy will. We give your name the praise and honor and glory in Jesus' name. Happy Father's Day, and thank you each and all in Jesus' name. Shake hands with one another. See you, brothers and sisters, right now. And if you want more cake, it's available to you.
He can't have.
Do you have tea, something?
You're gonna be, and you're gonna have to take a urine sample for the lab. She don't play that, no, she want him to be around till he about 2000. Believe me, I know I want this on.
You can, yeah.
Yeah, I just, I know I can't, I really, you know, because the first thing the man said to me Friday, you're doing good with the sweets. I said, yeah, thanks. Yeah, I can't, no pop.
Well, okay.
No pop.
Nothing, can't have sweet, no pop, none of that.
Can't have nothing.
You know what, that's sure, what, just your partner, what, how to tell?
What good guy I am, you know?
Nothing, red water, can't have one piece of that.
You suck to that, huh?
That's 8 ounces, I can have 8 ounces of living on that.
I can, yeah, I'm home.
I think we're gonna get together on what it is.
Yeah, I feel going by his house.
Okay, okay.
But I know, I think he's gonna be down there on the loop, I gotta find out, but he's using my brother's store.
Who's the loop, so he won't be able to do something?
I don't know, that's what I have to find out.
Okay, I got you.
He usually does, the last few years, 2 years that my brother's been downtown.
He was with him.
Then do scoop the loop then?
Yep, okay, okay.
I'll find out for sure.
That's all right, he gotta do what he gotta do.
Yeah, they had the gay parade somewhere today, and someplace else, they said it's not like Chicago, but I'm thinking, okay, you're promoting that.
All right.
That's not my kind of parade.
Nah, ain't nobody, nah, we know somebody, they call him Jesus.
You got your keys, Pastor?
Got the keys hanging right on my briefcase.
Got your phone?
Got my phone on my hip.
All right.
I got my keys.
He ain't gonna forget nothing, cause I always remind him. Get the keys, get the phone, get the computer.
Pastor, you going to your mom's?
Huh?
You going to your mom's?
No, my mother's?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Here's your cake, Pastor.
Okay, see.
How you gonna get that now?
Run real fast.
You gonna get it in the car?
Run real fast.
I put her a piece in there too.
A piece in there for?
Yeah, okay.
She actually ate a piece of my time, it was homemade.
Oh, did she?
Oh, you made that?
Mm-hmm.
I told you.
They know what you're doing.
No, I made.
I told you.
I have an area in my brother's store.
Oh, man.
Sister Broom is, she's sympathetic to us.
That is absolutely outstanding, that cake was awesome.
Thank you.
You can cook.
Well, I figured that, Tony.
But most people that cater can cook.
Yeah, but that bacon, you know, you gotta be right with that cake.
Well, Mama said, you can measure, you can bake it, you can't measure, you can't bake.
Right.
You know, Papa bakes.
I don't measure anything anymore.
Yeah, but Papa, whatever, you know, but Papa, you know, Paula Dean told, what's her girl name? The girl be on TV to do all right.
Who, Rachel Ray?
Yes, you know, she can't measure, and so sometimes her stuff be sticking.
Yeah.
Be burnt, you know, and she be.
She a home cook, yeah.
Yeah, but she cannot measure, and when you cannot measure.
Yeah, but she ain't been to school either.
Well, no, but you cannot bake if you cannot measure.
Well, it is what it is, and she getting fat, as I don't know what.
She getting fat?
Yeah, she getting fat, yeah, she getting fat, eating all that pasta.
Leave her pasta alone.
She eating that pasta.
Here we go.
That's it, we out here.
Find you right now.
You gonna be all right, come on, let's go.
Macaroni.
All right, you taking the hook, I'm taking the computer with you.
I'll come back for it.
You coming back for it?
I'm gonna move it.
Okay, so put it in the drawer, okay, cool. Make it sure.
Okay.
Okay.
The fans on timers, so they're going by themselves.
And then I don't use white sugar.
Brown sugar?
No, I use pure cane sugar.
I don't know what you use, but I know one thing, baby, I would not lie to you, if it wasn't good, I would say, that ain't that good. But that cake, baby, that was off the hook, I love it.
All right.
I thought you'd bought that from the store, you tricked me.